Where's my clipboard? Here's everything.
Pops left when he got bad. Laying pallets, all your clothes in a black bag. Almost drove that boy.
What's good, y'all? We back. We back. Something new going on. What is it called?
It's called Baz and Lock.
Yeah, we got other people in the back. Cousin, two cousins, but you don't see them though. But they here. Yeah, FM, sorry.
Hey, let's start with some motivation though.
Go first?
Damn. Alright, whatever. Yo, motivation. We want to get motivation to entrepreneurs. Anybody that's starting their grind, like Dip Hugs would say, once you start, you just gotta continue. Never finish. Never stop. I mean, if you're gonna do something, you better just die by it. And that's what we trying to motivate you today with.
Yeah, my motivation, I would just say, for all entrepreneurs, I know I always say keep going. I'm not going to say that this time. I would just say just have tunnel vision. That's better. Just have tunnel vision. Have tunnel vision. Yes. Oh, yeah. And we is working on new footage, too. So
check that out.
Yes, sir. But investing.
But into entrepreneurship, we wanted to talk about, like, real life. Like, yeah. Like, you got aspirations of being something, being somebody, selling clothes, making films, videos, doing
everything,
it all. Everything, right? Everything.
I'm just saying, what we wanted to talk about in this episode, at least to start it off with some motivation, is just like, how can you say it? Like, problems that everybody go through dealing with as entrepreneurs. So, like, as entrepreneurs, everybody might not have the same vision as everybody else might have. We might not have it. And then also with that, we'll just talk about literally just investing in your fucking business and shit and investing in your equipment, like, as you should. Like, we done cashed out, not cashed out, but like we just spending on what we got to spend it on just so that we could bring better footage and better quality for y'all. Like, just to show you that we serious and you know what I mean? This is what we trying to do.
I feel what you're trying to say is like, don't let somebody with a $40,000 salary a year get in the middle of your $1 million dreams.
Basically. Yeah. So, yeah. I mean, WAP, you can give us through. Yeah, like, struggles that you deal with as entrepreneur, the struggles that you deal
like,
with.
Like, even as an entrepreneur, it's like, you be wanting your friends to, like, go all in with your business. And sometimes you got to realize it's like, everybody dream not your dream. And people going to come along to help your dream. And people going to come along to kind of, like, not say, like, take you from your dream, but have you struggling to accomplish your dream. And it only gonna make you stronger, to be honest.
Yes, sir.
Not only that, niggas, yo. Niggas, like, niggas close to you won't support you sometimes.
That shit hurt, bro.
Won't support you. Like, niggas you grew up with. But, like,
nah.
Bottom merch, like, nah. They.
Why is it that you hurt, though?
Niggas not hurt, but, like, at the
same time. No, I'm just saying, like, why is it that you feel some type of way with somebody close to you not supporting you?
Because that nigga supporting niggas from...
That he don't even know, yeah, right? Yeah, bro. It's just like, they might have somebody locally that's really putting the work in and the hours in, but he might be ass, though. He might be ass, or at least that nigga doing more work than you is.
It's not that he ass. It's like he just didn't get the hit. Like, if you make him, if you making music, it's like... Everybody make a hit that's gonna have everybody jumping,
right?
And then you're gonna have songs where like that was alright, but it's not it.
Niggas won't support you until they see like somebody popping supporting you,
basically.
You know what I mean?
But
they still buying Gucci, but Gucci don't fuck with you.
Yeah,
I mean they do got Dapper Dan there, but I ain't gonna shit.
I feel you, but that shit just like it basically like leads over to religion and like what your faith is. So when you going out on that leap of faith or something that you want to do and nobody else is doing it, it's like you gotta have some type of faith or religion backing you. I mean, I'm gonna speak for myself. I'm not gonna say for everybody else, but you know what I mean. Faith of the mustard seed. So that's actually one of my logos anyway. So
faith of the mustard seed. Faith,
yeah, it's like a mustard seed, like this small, but you gotta have the faith of a mustard seed. So I was like a little faith like that.
You saying that because the mustard seed grow or something?
Yes.
Yeah. I'm supposed to know that.
How big are you gonna pause?
I'm not sure, bro, but it's just a phrase that they use in the Bible. That's all I was just trying to say.
I ain't trying to shit on your phrase. I'm just sense of it. I never heard of it.
You just gotta have the faith of a mustard seed. Like if you put a mustard seed in somebody's hand, that shit is like it's small. You gotta have
that. It's like even when that faith, like once you have it, it's like once you keep like traveling on your path, you keep getting reminded of your faith on your travels and keep like recognition that you're doing the right thing and you following your path. So that's faith, all. That's all. I was about
faith
to say.
Is like without, like you can't see, like you can't really see it. You just gotta like keep going and just be praying that shit is it'll go good. Not pray that it, obviously pray to go good, but
basically gotta see the light. I wanted to play that
out of no light.
There's no cap, bitch.
Is it time? Look, I spent my whole life trying to improvise. I'm not saying that shit for you to sympathize. Spent my whole life trying to find the light that's at the end of the tunnel. I should've realized it was inside. So lately I've been trying to get what's inside outside. So many people wanna see my insides outside. I'm from that city 4 hours east to south side, where everyone outside but don't fuck with no outside. It's going up with the ones I hold it down with. Whole city got my back on some photobomb shit. Whole city blowing up on some most of down shit. Before this I was the one host tried to go to prime with. You know, take the fame, take the crib, take our cars, now we gotta take the train. Hood niggas taking chains, slave master take our names, 5-0 take the shot, and young souls take the blame, man. But they can't take away the light.
No matter how much they gon' shade you,
man, they can't fuck with the light.
They can't stop the shine.
They can't fuck with the light. Hell no, the boy's that bright. Even if you take away my life, you can't take the light.
No matter how much they gon' shade.
Got the whole city on fire. Boy, this the flow that got Steph Curry inspired. This the flow that got LeBron James finna rewire. This the flow that got my whole family finna retire. Flows on flows, I might drown in this bitch. Yay, found a pro, I guess I'm profound in this bitch. My dad from Louisiana, man, the smallest town, where if they know you're brown, they might hold you down and even hold you down, man. Since I'm a son, I feel like I gotta stunt hard. I took the hand that they gave me and played the Donald Trump card and realized counting money never feel as good as counting blessings, and the load of mine is more dangerous than the load of weapons. So when they take the fame, take the crib, take our cars, now we gotta take the train. And hood niggas taking chains, slave master take our names, 5-0 take the shot, and young souls take the blame, man. That they can't take away the light.
No matter how much they gon' shade you,
man, they can't fuck with the light.
They can't stop the shine.
Nope, they can't fuck with the light.
Can't fuck with the light, my nigga. My shit. Yo, this shit banging now. You hear that music?
Yes, Sir.
Yeah, somebody probably be calling a banger right now. Story time.
Basically, it's about a time and this time when we was in a situation that we didn't basically want to be in.
Oh, that's the story time. That's the question of the story time today.
Yeah, have you ever been in? All right,
because you interrupted me. That's cool.
I'm sorry.
No, man, it's cool. I don't want to fight you.
Damn.
I know, right? No, let me tell your story then. Since you like,
I was gonna let you go.
No, because you interrupted me. No,
go ahead,
no,
bro.
Finish it.
Go,
no,
bro.
Finish it.
Go.
What was your situation that you didn't want to be in?
I was about to roll. That's why I just.
No, you. Fuck it up. You was smoking the face anyway. Go.
Yo, he got it out for me today, dog.
No cap.
But no, a situation I would say. It was my last year of school. I had went to go grab something, and I basically was at the bar for too long. And I was out for too long. Huh? I was drunk. I was high. I was trying to make it home. I had a game the next day. It was like 5 o'clock in the morning. I tried to make it home. I swear I tried. But I fell asleep at the light in Coshocton in the log. Pulled up when I woke, when I just know I was at the line. I was like, let me just sit back for a little bit. Let me just chill. It's a dead moment. That's the situation. I fuck up the car.
You fell asleep in your car.
I was at
a red light?
Yeah.
All the
bro,
time?
You ever been? You ever
wait,
been?
Wait. This is a natural day.
I knew something.
Yeah,
like, yo, that shit.
Y'all don't get your 8 hours of sleep? What's
bro,
up?
Listen.
Talk to me. Talk to me. Fuck it.
I don't know if it was that. I went to daydream. I went to DC. Look, I had to go to DC to talk to the governors and shit for my class and shit.
But you was in Coshocton.
But no, this was like I had to get up 4 in the morning for that. Then I went to the bar. I had practice. Then I went to the bar. Then I stayed out all night. And then I was trying to make it home. It's like 5 o'clock in the morning. I didn't go to sleep.
Oh,
see, he had all that stuff.
I've been up since 4 a.m. And I'm just like, I was trying to make it home. Bro, when I mean I was cutting through stop signs.
I get you.
I was trying to make it like this. I was like, hold up, let me wait for like 5 minutes, right? I'm like this.
Never work.
I said,
he's right there for an hour, too.
Yo, he said, yo, you've been here for 20 minutes. I said, you fraud. Take your foot off the brake. Take your foot off the brake. I said, yo.
He thought you was about to drive off. What?
Bro, that shit was the worst.
Yeah, he tripping. I would have drove off, though,
but
by that time.
The long story about that.
No, long story short, though, I want hair. Why you go to the bar?
I was waiting for something. A package.
So you waiting for a package?
It took all day, and I just
was the package coming to the bar?
I just kept
you just got drinking.
Yeah, you know what I was drinking? This is how y'all going to know I didn't make it. I was drinking TP. Taylor's Port.
Teleport?
Yes.
That shit, yo.
Deadly.
Mix that shit with Hennessy?
I would never.
I would never.
He's in the building.
I proposed to the bitch.
Oh, yeah, it's deaf.
I proposed to that bitch.
You what?
Some bitch.
You proposed to some bitch.
Yeah, bro.
But you don't remember the bitch name? You just don't want to
repeat. I don't want to.
Because you proposed to her.
Listen.
I repeat, don't mix Henny and TP.
That? Or you just proposing?
No. I didn't know that. Like,
it was what's your story you ain't want to be in, though?
Shit. First time I got gun posing.
Oh, you a killer.
Nah, sixth grade. No.
Sixth grade?
Sixth grade.
What the hell you was doing? Throw somebody pack?
Nah, dumb nigga shit. You know how young boy days after school you throwing rocks at cars and shit?
No,
I never did that
like,
dumb shit.
You know how young boy days after school you throwing rocks at cars and shit?
No, I never did that dumb shit.
As a matter of fact,
one of these motherfuckers hit you with a rock. I think it was you. You threw a rock at me though, just one time.
You started ratting, right? You started ratting on your face.
No, but he threw a rock at my bitch though, like it was nuts.
What I really
is my shit at.
You just trying to be funny and you ain't think it was gonna hit me and it did. That's all.
What?
Yeah.
No,
And get your nut ass out of here, nigga.
You was on the bunny?
Yo, you know where James used to be at?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was my right shit
there,
too.
You told me it was me and him and a couple of our niggas.
We see a lot of white.
We were just chugging rocks like 3 cars. Next thing you know, they were just.
Bro, that shit was the move back then, bro.
No, it wasn't. Shit, the move that niggas used to do is fucking with the carts, had them joints running into the boulevard and then go running.
Y'all just some badass kids, dog.
I do that shit.
One time situation, I was fucked up, man. So I was like, you ever been like in a situation where you wasn't like, you was just trying to do some normal shit, regular shit? Like just buy some chips from the store? And you walking with some homies at yours and shit, you know what I mean? Not realizing that they had no money. So I walk in, I'm taking my time, not knowing what's going on.
How old are you?
I'm definitely like 11 or 12.
Everybody stole.
You know what I mean? So they started grabbing, and my dumb ass didn't know that they was going to steal. So I'm at the register buying shit, and we all walk in together. And then they start trying to get me arrested.
Oh, yeah. The niggas you was with?
No, because they ran out, and I didn't know they were stealing stuff.
But you got money in your pockets, right?
I paid, too.
You feel me? Fuck you, try.
Now I'm mad, because I could have stole something, too. If then
I would have said, I'm not told with me. Them niggas.
Right, like, I got money
I
in
paid.
My pocket.
You just seen me pay high stuff. I just paid.
She just knew my mom, though. That's the only like, thing that saved me.
You hanging with them niggas. You hanging with the wrong niggas.
Your mom didn't whoop you back then?
No, I was paying for some shit. She was like, you a dumbass. Your dumbass walked around with bad crowd. I was like, all right, you right.
Walking with the wrong niggas.
I don't talk to the nigga that only smoke faces, bro. I only talk to niggas that share. What's up, D?
I ain't telling my story
today.
I
thought you did.
No, y'all skipped me.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, F. I'm talking.
Go ahead, bro.
Sensitive. Oh, yeah, but like, so we throwing rocks. My man's, on the other hand, he threw that rock, but he ain't tell nobody he threw it.
Oh, all right. So you like, one of my situations.
So like, we walking, he just hit it. Bow! But we get to the alleyway. That's when we all start splitting up and shit. It's like his crib this way, my crib that way, and my other man's crib that way. Car pull up.
They chase you?
Nah, they ain't. So, car pull up. Bro,
it's story time. It's story time. So, it's classic. All
my
men
start running. I start running. I turn around. This one, it's that one dickhead in the group.
Oh, all right.
That stays in shit.
Oh, no, nah, that was me.
So he stayed. I'm like, damn, that's my man.
What he say? I ain't do nothing.
No. So I'm like, damn, that's my man. I can't leave him by himself.
So you got saving?
I go back.
Hero.
And shit. So, both of Jamaican. I'm a stop hanging out the one people that all that shit. My man just had seizures back there. She like, all that shit, bro. But when every time he have it, I crack the fuck up.
I know why.
I'm dying. Like, every time. This nigga be in class and he walk into the teacher. All that, and I started busting now in your class.
Bro.
What's up with you, dog?
Yo, you fucked up individual.
Yeah. He knows it's funny, though, so he be free sometimes.
Right. That's not even funny, dog.
Boy turned around. Hold that shit to me and shit.
Mm.
Like, I could, like, see the hole and shit. I'm like.
Laughing while it's fucking, then you turn around, he just stand holding the gun at you.
Boom. No, he ain't shooting.
Listen.
I got you. You got nominee though, right? Cause I had DJ Academics.
Why at?
Yeah. You didn't hear what he did?
He read it on me?
Yeah, green light. It green light.
That might be mine too though, bro. I couldn't get over it.
But
I'm sorry, I really couldn't get over it though.
I heard about it.
That shit was nutty. Y'all didn't expect that from a nigga like him?
I mean,
he's not a street nigga. He hanging out with 6ix9ine.
Okay, I see what you want to say, but still, it's like,
you feel me?
Yo, the funny thing is, Philly Scoop Hall like got a thing out for him. Like, he posts every day something nutty about DJ Academics.
The funny thing is though, it's like he telling niggas that he a rat,
bro.
Right?
He's not a street nigga.
Ain't that funny? You seen the joint with the 6ix9ine tried to get on the freestyle? I mean, like like you know how everybody had like freestyle in the basement and shit like, and everybody used to come in freestyle. Yeah, some joint, but they from like overseas though.
Oh.
And 6ix9ine asked to get in there, and he was like, "You not no fucking rapper." And he was like, "Fuck you, fat bitch." And he was like, "All right, Master Splinter."
Oh shit.
Like, he just drilled on it. So I mean, I don't know.
So it seemed like everybody just gonna say dickhead of the week Academics.
Yeah.
low key though, because he on some blatantly shit. Like, if you say green light, I'm telling the cops.
I see what you're saying.
I ain't, listen.
You used to watch him? I seen somebody like comment like that. He's like, I used to fuck with him, but I stopped posting. I stopped following him after all this shit.
I still subscribe to this nigga. I ain't expect nothing more from him.
He's not no straight
nigga.
Well, you watch DJ Vlad then?
Yeah, I watch
Vlad. I don't fuck with him either, man.
Fun fact for y'all.
What's a fun fact?
Did y'all know Jay-Z wrote Still Dre?
Yeah.
Y'all seen it today? I never knew that.
I just found that shit yesterday.
I just found it out today. I didn't know.
All right, you want to get into current? So, dickhead of the week. You know what I mean?
Dickhead, listen.
Academics, man.
Get your nut ass out of here, nigga.
Let me ask y'all, since y'all have been paying attention to sports, right? You seen about the boy Jonathan Isaac?
Oh, torn ACL.
Yeah, but he stood up for.
That's God telling you, dickhead.
And get your nut ass out of here, nigga.
I don't know. You might be right though, bro. That's weird though.
He a house nigga.
Me and my man had a whole discussion, and they was basically saying, if you're not kneeling for that, then what you standing for?
You feel me?
Listen, so what you stand for then? Like,
the kneeling part.
There's no other way around it. I'm a nut ass nigga. When that shit happened at school, they asked us, did y'all want to kneel? Like, they asked, because it was white players on our team.
Don't tell me you said, nah.
What?
You didn't want to kneel.
Nah, but.
They gave y'all a chance?
Wait, what?
They
asked the black students, right?
They was just like, if y'all want to kneel, just let me know so we all can kneel. Don't just like.
And don't
tell him and shit. No, we didn't know, but that was like
my coach ain't giving us. He said, I don't care what y'all you mean.
He told us we was talking about it, but that shit ain't hit me like as much as like
now though.
It did recently.
But like, you wasn't worried about that.
That's crazy.
And I ain't gonna lie, I feel like a lot of people probably they are now. They gotta be now.
That's crazy, bro.
See, my coach, his dumb mess about him. I don't care what y'all you mean. We gonna do that shit over here. Your black ass up.
Yeah. I thought you were going to talk about waiters.
Wait. You know,
cheese.
Come on, man.
No.
You know how, even though we lost.
I thought you was going to be the first one to talk about waiters. You were the last one co-signing.
He did good, and then we lost the game the other night to Toronto. That's cool. Toronto is stamped a little bit to me. They stamped. I watched their game today, too. You seen the game today? I was watching the game earlier.
What the fuck is wrong with Philly? That's what I want to know. Stupid.
I lost hope, bro.
Dickhead, listen.
I lost hope.
That's why you don't talk about them no more?
Facts. I lost hope.
Yo, he not a real fan. WAP is not a real fan. When it gets bad, he don't stand by his team. You heard what he just said. He lost hope, and we got it on film. He lost hope. When the Lakers had Jordan Clarkson, Earl Clark, all these butt-ass niggas, dog, I was with us. I was still rocking with this. You better stand by your team.
All right, I only stand by Milano.
Don't say I lose.
I only stand by Milano. I don't stand with no fucking team, nigga.
Yo,
what
this you talking man. About?
Bro, like, what's up with them, though?
Did you hear what he just said?
Yeah, I lost hope a little bit, too.
You don't hear what he just said.
What you said?
I stand with Milano. I don't stand with no fucking team.
You didn't hear what he said.
Well, shit. Milano. Justice for Milano. I'm just saying where I stand. When you tell me you stand with the Sixers, I stand with Milano before I stand with Ben Simmons or Joel Embiid, nigga. What are you talking about?
You don't get it, dude.
I don't get it. Talk about that Meek shit?
Yeah, he hurt about that. He don't like what Meek did. Just tell
me. Meek a quarterball for that. Fuck yeah.
Facts.
Oh,
201.
That's my quarterball. First of all, bro, y'all spent the whole time.
Facts.
Niggas don't even know 100% you're in a relationship until y'all had the baby. Then boom, y'all come out of nowhere, me and Milano. We going to court parents. Shut the fuck up. That's why Achilles volleys, you pussy.
Picture worth it. I mean, I got the picture right there. Yeah, right? I stand with her, yo. Justice for Milano.
But, like, why would you go to social media and say something like that? Just kept on doing what you was doing.
Y'all probably would have kept wondering. So he just got it over with.
I tell you why,
you
bro.
You a celebrity for a reason,
You want the scoop?
Why?
He got another joint pregnant, bro. She about to spread the news, dog. That he's trying to get ahead of it. Trying to tell you. You were now.
What would you do in that situation?
You think it's about that Kim shit?
I would stand with
both.
I think
it's about that Kim.
You think he got?
And then like I was actually waiting for you to say something about J. Cole.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Think about going to the NBA, right?
To me, bro, that shit is like. That shit is like a slap in the face to niggas that's really working to get in.
He played college ball.
I'm just saying.
Nice.
Bro, I'm not, played bro, college I'm not ball. Trying to hear that, bro. Niggas really got
He
resume.
Went to St. John.
All right, bro.
Whatever,
bro. You ain't on J. Cole right now?
No.
But listen, though. If you say...
I'm just saying, up. That's just going to be like a slap in the face to the niggas
to
that...
To who?
To the niggas that
to
really...
Who?
To some... To like certain niggas that's
nigga,
really
NBA
not...
is a business, nigga.
That's what I'm saying. If he good enough, they're going
to
get him.
If he good enough to play on the court...
So the other niggas that's not... Getting in the lead, bro.
Sometimes
that
it's like, sometimes
working.
It's like politics. Sometimes it's
like, it's all that.
It's a lot of shit. Sometimes
it's all
yeah,
that.
They, bro,
I'm just saying, if a rapper trying to hoop, shit. Who a team they said he was gonna hoop for?
Charlotte.
Why, they need him.
They ass.
They need him.
Listen,
let him wear 23 too.
They ass. You know how
Michael Jordan number,
bro. You know how many tickets they gonna sell just because they got J. Cole in there?
Duh.
That's
I'm why. Saying, you a hater.
That don't mean he good.
Because he sell out arenas, and rapping and balling.
I'm not talking about nothing.
You a hater.
Bro, somebody in the G League that'll probably bust his ass bad and could take his spot. What do you think?
But he ain't going to sell as many jerseys as J. Cole, nigga. What the fuck is you talking
it's
about?
It's a business at
you
the end of the day.
You proving my point.
I'm telling you why he there. He spent.
I know he there for a business, but that don't mean he good.
He's definitely got an eighth man rotation. He definitely could be the fucking
bro. He
could be the Eric Snow of your team. Fuck is you talking about?
He be playing with them niggas though.
What that mean?
With them ball players and shit. If he catch keeping up with them in the gym, come on now. You know who I'm trying to see for in the league for real?
Oh,
Dave East.
Nah, that's just dicky.
Dave
East can't even play ball.
He did play.
No,
ball.
No, he like Snoop Dogg playing ball. You ever seen Snoop Dogg play ball?
Yeah, I seen Snoop.
He could play ball.
Nah.
Oh, all right.
Like me playing
not really. Not
that's
really,
what I'm saying. But
really.
But niggas always love to play see Snoop Dogg in a celebrity game.
I don't.
That's Uncle Snoop.
Shit. I'd rather see Kevin Hart. Kevin Hart could ball a little bit.
Fuck out of here.
And he strapped up Kyle.
Yo, you just talk shit. You just talk shit about J. Cole and you going.
I know you see that dude. He strapped Kyle Lowry up. So I'm just saying.
You're
like,
ass nigga, yo.
I'm just saying.
Three-point contest against him too?
I don't know. I don't know all that.
I think he did.
I don't know all of that.
I'm not going back and forth with y'all.
I don't know.
Yo. That shootout, Philadelphia shootout. I heard about that?
He didn't want to put no mask on.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Was he white?
That was different. That was different, I'll tell you that.
Right, was he
alive,
was he,
right?
Was he
that's what I heard, right?
Was he white? Like
that was some Kevin type shit?
Bro, it was bad. I'll tell you that. It was bad. I seen that shit, but I didn't want
to. Let me ask you this. Is this a black or white name? Adam Zborowski.
He from overseas.
First of all, how many black people can drive around with an AK every day? Like, nobody.
Like,
what the
like.
Fuck?
First of all, I'm going
to be shy. Nah, you think I got Adam in my phone? I got a picture of Milano, nigga, not Adam in my phone. Nigga, what's wrong with you?
Shoot
your
shot.
What I?
Listen.
Thanks, yo. Look at me.
look
at me. Milano, I'm trying to tell you, yo. If anything, we nuts. Fuck a dream chaser.
Damn, like that?
I'm a life chaser.
You better chill before Melly come get you.
Yeah, that's a fact though. But you asked me for Melly that last week. Remember that that shit you was talking?
Bro, everybody see that.
But you was making fun of it though.
I wasn't making fun of him.
You was like, you told it to come back at Cooley. You did say that. Now I'm snitching.
Ah, spit some boy right there for Melly.
Oh shit, you definitely.
Yeah.
All right, yo, but you did say Jay-Z wrote Still Dre, right? What y'all think about that?
He wrote the whole joint.
What that mean, like Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg, not rap receiver?
Dr. Dre,
not a tough rapper though. Like
Dr. Dre never wrote his shit.
That's a fact.
He never was. Snoop only had like a couple like Snoop had like a couple bars and shit like that. He didn't have a whole. You mean?
You talking about Murder She Wrote? He didn't write that whole joint. That was my shit.
Bro, I don't know, man.
Snoop wrote that.
I hope so. If not,
Still man. Dre. That's the only thing he. You mean he didn't?
But it's like every year some shit like that happened. I remember when somebody said somebody wrote Jay-Z lyrics, like Big Daddy Kane or somebody wrote.
I take
Pippin
that.
Or something.
But I'm saying though, Snoop came out and said Jay-Z wrote that song for them.
The whole joint. I couldn't believe it. The whole joint.
But Snoop didn't have no crazy bars in that.
I'm just saying, ain't that
right? You feel me?
I'm just saying, you don't think that's the whole joint? God damn.
The whole joint was Dre for real. Snoop just saying that.
I know, but ain't it just crazy, though? I didn't know that. When did y'all know that? Y'all
I ain't know that. Nah, I ain't know that.
How'd you know that?
I heard about it.
Oh. I didn't know that.
Oh, so it's not the first time it's going around now?
You know, like, ask you, like, you can look up, like, writers on
yeah,
each song.
I just, I don't
take
know.
Take the time.
My bad, slow moment.
That's I heard cool. Somebody wrote for Meek, but.
Who, Quentin? Nah, I'm fucking with you. That's a bad lie. Going to break? We about to be over.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I thought you was going to, like, go, yeah.
We talk about current already, that's what I'm saying.
I'm going to shout out, right?
Yeah, shout out.
I'm gonna shout out Entrepreneurs Today. I had my own one bags shout out. I was just hooping with them the other day, and I see how far you come, and I want you to keep going. And I know you got that special drop dropping in like 4 days. Shout out to Hard Over Hype. And he has something dropping in a couple days. So I'm going to make sure I tag him in this and everything. So that's my nominee for today.
I wanted to shout out Mabel Marie. Like, they've been around for like years. So. Photo catalog on Instagram. So for them to still be around, just like give me hope to like, I mean, have my name like them kind of. Everybody that's popping.
If you're not popping, keep grinding, dog.
Bro,
you a hater.
What's popping to you? When I say popping, you doing your shit.
It's popping if I like it.
You doing your shit. Everybody that's popping, like say, all right, say your line to me is popping.
Mm-hmm.
But some other nigga, oh no, he's not there yet.
Oh, I want the smoke though.
You want the smoke with him?
I want the smoke with him. You want to thank the studio? Thank On Air Sir. You want to thank?
Yeah, you know, shout out to Sir, On Air with Sir. Oh my god!
God damn!
Damn.
God damn! God, no warning.
Sup? Tight. But yeah, shout out to Sir. This new space that we're recording in. So you know, expect better things. Look out for visuals too, because we will be dropping them joints too. Look out for skits. Look out for all of that we dropping. Merch too.
Music reactions, right? Music reactions.
Yeah, we
right. FM. If it don't happen, curse that nigga out. Coming That's a soon. Fact.
And so
coming soon.
We'll be working. We're gonna close it out.
Yeah, I got this song, Playboi Carti. I wanted to get hyped for it.
I'm replay shit. Me and my bitch, nigga. Give me my whole nigga. We do this shit with my bitch, nigga. Know what I'm saying? We do this shit with my bitch, nigga. Walking that shit. Take over that bitch. I'm in the hood with niggas don't bother me. 3500 my cardigan. Shawty gon' fuck, shawty gon' swallow me. Shawty gon' get on top of me. I did that ice in the summertime. Ain't no boy fucking with Cardi, nah.
I'm in this bitch ring on Cardi. Riding around with the top down. All these bitches so naughty. They tryna fuck on us right now. If Cardi with it, then I'm riding. Got 100 on the neck. Ain't no stopping, bitch, I'm popping. You see this rolling in the chain? Bitch, I'm so icy, I'm cocky. Just dropped the 50 on my jeweler and told her make sure it's shiny. It's cold hard and she got a stick. Right beside me, I'ma let it hit. Ain't really with the sucker shit. These niggas around me, you know they with it. Yeah, these niggas around me, you know they with it. They toting them glass and them dirty sticks. Yeah, I back up hard and they gon' pull up quick. They ready for what? Yeah, you know they with it.
Make sure you go subscribe, like, follow, comment. Anything else? Anything else? Nah.
Tune in, man.
Let us know what you want to talk about.
Triggers, no cap, bitch. How you get?